1. This is a lesson on how we find a general formula for a particular sequence or pattern. The first term is minus 1, then we get 5, 11, 17. This is the pattern that we have been given. So when you calculate, when you find the general term, you have to have the first term, common difference. Common difference, it should be common for every terms I'm going to show you. Multiplied by 1, the 1 is for the first term. And then you need to find a particular number. And this is the answer that you get from the first term. Second term, common difference multiplied by 2. 2 is for the second term. And then you add a particular number that you're going to find. And then equals to my second term. My second term is 5. Term 3, same thing. The 3 is for the third term. And my term 3 is 11. Term 4, the 4 is for the fourth term. And my term 4 is 70. Okay, let me show you how we do that. Let's first find the common difference. We're going to write it as D. You always write this term minus that term. This term minus that term. This. So you're going to start with 17 minus 11. Then you get a 6. The D is for the common difference. You don't do it once. You have to try it to see that you're getting the same number all the time. 11 minus 5, you get a 6. And then you have a common difference, 5 minus minus 1 is equal to negative times negative is positive, plus 5, you get a 6. So you're going to, our common difference, you see it's common, you get this 6 all the time. So it's a common difference because we're subtracting. Let's write this with the common difference instead of writing the name. So term 1 is equals to, my common difference is 6. And then I multiply with a 1. 1 for the first term. And I'm going to add a particular number. I need to find that number that I'm going to add. And then my total is supposed to be minus 1. Okay. So if I multiply 6 times 1, I'm going to get a 6. Then I must add to another number to get a minus 1. So you get that by saying minus 1 minus 6. You get a minus 7. So if I have a 6, then I minus a 7, I'll get a minus 1. Okay? Term 2 is equals to 6 times 2 from term 2 plus a particular number that I'm gonna find is equals to, what is my term 2? My term 2 is 5. Okay, so I have 6 times 2, which is 12, plus I must add another number to get a 5. So how am I gonna get that? I'm gonna say 5 minus 12. 5 minus 12, then I get a minus 7. Term 3 is equals to 6 times 3 for term 3 plus a particular number. What is the value for term 3? 11. Okay. And then 6 times 3 is 18. So I'm going to have 11 minus 18. Then I get a minus 7. Term 4 is equals to 6 times 4 plus a particular number. And then my term 4 is 17. I need to find that particular number that I add to 6 times 4. 6 times 4 is 24. 24 plus what will give me 17? So I get 17 minus 24 minus 7. Okay, now the general term. The general term, this word general means it works all the time. So if I choose to call it T term N, meaning term, any term, is equals to 6 times. Do you remember when we had a 4, we had a 4. When it was a 3, 3, 2, 2, 1, 1. So it means when I have an N, I'll have an N here. Plus, you see here, it's plus and minus. Positive times negative, it will be negative 7. So my general term is 6N minus 7. When you look at this, all these terms, you are having that constant 7. So if I multiply 6 by N, I get, and minus 7, I get the term. So this is the general term. Now let's check if it's correct.
Okay.
Let's choose term 4. Let's have a 4 here. Is equal to 6 times 4 minus 7. Our fourth term is 17. 1, 2, 3, 4. The fourth term is 17. So we're expecting that to be 17. Then our general formula is correct. Let's see. 6 times 4 minus 7 is equal to 17. So it's correct. Why do you need to find the general formula? So that you can find any term in the sequence. Let's say they've asked you term 40. You don't need to write all the terms until you get to the 40th one. When you use the formula, term 40, in the end I wrote 40. So you'll have 6 times 40 minus 7. 6 times 40 minus 7. It's 233. It means in this sequence, the 40th term will be 233. So this is the way that you find the general formula. You don't have to write these patterns all the time. Let's look at another example. Let's look at this example. Let's say we're given this pattern 5, 9, 13, and 17. The first thing, find the common difference. D is equals to 17 minus 13. 17 minus 13 is equals to 4. D is equals to 13 minus 9 is equals to 4. D is equals to 9 minus 5 is equals to 4. It's important to go through this step to make sure that you have the common difference. You are subtracting and it's common. It's 4, 4, 4. So you have the common difference. Now, if you have this, you remember that our general formula is Tn plus the common difference n plus a particular number. Okay, let's see how we find it. See this step that you do over and over again. You needed to do that to prove that it works. You don't have to do all the time. You can use one term. I suggest you use the easiest one. Usually the first term is the easiest one. So T1 is equals to, my common difference is 4 times 1 plus, I need a particular number, and then I must get a 5. Okay? 4 times 1 plus a particular number will give me 5. That number is 1. So you don't have to try it over and over again. So you have Tn is equals to 4 times n plus 1. This is your general formula. You found the general formula like this. Now, if you have to write it, you say it in words. What does it mean? It means you have a term number. This is a term number. You multiply with a 4 and add a 1. Then you find the pattern. You can find any pattern in the sequence. Thank you for watching. This is the end of our lesson.